Hello students, in our previous class we have discussed about discharge of contract. That means how a contract comes to an end in different ways. Now we are going to discuss second subunit of second unit, that is remedies for breach of contract. Now what does it mean by breach of contract? So breach of contract, when the contract comes to an end, and it comes to an end because of the fault of one of the parties to the contract. So contract comes to an end because one party commits a breach, one party breaks the terms of the contract, one party is not ready to perform his part of contract, because of that the contract is broken, contract comes to an end. Now what are the remedies for the other party to the contract? When one party commits a breach of contract, when one party is not ready to perform his part of contract, what the other party will do, what are the remedies available to the other party? Parties to a lawful contract are bound to perform their obligations. So it is a legal duty which is devolved or which is there on the parties, and they have to perform their obligations under the contract. But when one of the parties refuses to perform his obligation, he is said to have committed breach of contract. So it is the duty, it is the legal obligation, legal duty of parties to perform their part of contract, to perform what they have decided to do. But when one party is ready to perform his part of contract, another party is not ready. That means that another party has committed breach of contract. In case of breach of contract, the law provides following remedies to an injured party. Injured party, whenever a breach is committed, there will be two parties. One is the injured party. Injured party means it is also known as aggrieved party. So that party is one party who is ready to perform his duties, and another party is not ready for that. In that case, what are the remedies which are available to the injured party, that means aggrieved party? So for example, there is a contract between A and B. A says to B that I am ready to sell my horse to you for 10,000 rupees. B says that yes, tomorrow I will give you 10,000 rupees, you give your horse to me. So it is a contract between both of them. Both of them have legal duty towards each other. What is A's duty? A's duty is to give horse to B. What is B's duty? After taking a horse, pay for that, give 10,000 rupees to A. Both parties will have certain duties towards each other. Next day, B comes with 10,000 rupees to A and says that as per our agreement, as per our contract, I have brought 10,000 rupees here, take these 10,000 rupees and give me your horse. A says that no, I am not going to give my horse to you, because C wants to purchase my horse for 15,000. So who has committed breach of contract? A has committed breach of contract. So it was decided that A is going to sell horse to B and B is going to give 10,000 rupees to A. B is ready to perform his legal obligation, his duty. He is ready to pay 10,000 rupees. But A is not ready to perform his part of contract. That means A has committed breach of contract. Now, what are the remedies which are available to the injured party or aggrieved party? Now, who is an aggrieved party here? B is an aggrieved party in this case. So, what are the remedies which will be available to B? So, as per law, there are certain remedies. First is cancellation or rescission, restitution, specific performance, injunction, quantum merit. So these are the remedies which are available to the injured party. So if you see the previous year's question paper, and sixth point is damages. So this topic of remedies for breach of contract is very important. Often asked question for 15 marks question, what are the remedies for breach of contract? So one by one we will discuss these points. First point is cancellation or rescission. Rescission means, we have seen that cancelling the contract. So the party under voidable contract, that party has a right to rescind the contract, right to cancel the contract. So where one of the parties to contract commits breach, one party to the contract commits breach, the other party, that means injured party or aggrieved party, may treat the contract as rescinded. So other party may consider that the contract has been cancelled. And after he considers that the contract is cancelled, he is free from all the obligations under the contract. So A and B, here B, whichever example we had taken, B is ready to pay 10,000 rupees. Now what is this remedy says? This remedy says B will treat that the contract has been cancelled between A and B to sell the horse, and henceforth he is also free from the obligation under the contract. If next day A comes and says that now I am ready to sell my horse to you again for 10,000 rupees, purchase it. No, B is not under an obligation to give 10,000 rupees and take that horse. So he may treat the contract as cancelled, and after considering like that, he will be free from the obligations under the contract. Section 75 says that a contract who rightfully rescinds a person who rightfully rescinds a contract is entitled to compensation for damages he sustained through non-fulfillment of contract. So if the person suffers any kind of monetary loss because of cancellation of such a contract, in that case, he can claim those damages from the person who has committed breach from that person, whatever loss he has suffered because of non-fulfillment of contract. Say, for example, in the same case, there is a contract between A and B, and A refuses to purchase, to give the horse to B. In that case, B will cancel that contract. Next day, B has to purchase another horse from someone else for rupees 12,000. So what is the loss which he has suffered? He suffered a loss of 2,000 rupees. That loss which he has suffered because of non-fulfillment of contract, he can claim that from A by, as a compensation for committing breach of contract. So this is the first point, cancellation or rescission. Second point is restitution. Restitution means what? Restitution means return of benefit received by one party to the contract from the other party under a void contract. So when one party has received something under a contract and that contract becomes void, if that party has received something, he has to return it to the party from whom he has received it. Section 65 provides that when an agreement is void, any person who has received advantage under such agreement or contract, he is bound to restore it or to make compensation for it to the person from whom he received. So the contract becomes void. The person has received something by way of an advance money. In the case of horse, sale and purchase of horse, we'll take an example. Example is A pays B rupees 1,000. A pays rupees 1,000 and says that in consideration, in return, what he has to do, B promises to marry C, who is A's daughter. A pays B rupees 1,000. In return, what B has to do, B promises to marry C, A's daughter. C is dead at the time of promise. Such agreement is void. Now what money B has received, B has to return that money. Or we'll take an example which we have already taken. There is an agreement between A and B to sell the horse. A says that I'm ready to sell my horse to you for 10,000 rupees. B says that I'm ready to purchase it for 10,000 rupees. B pays 2,000 rupees by way of an advance to A. He says that tomorrow you are going to give your horse to me. I have to pay 10,000 rupees. So to book the horse or to give the advance money, 2,000 rupees by way of an advance, I will be giving you today. But the horse dies before the contract is to be performed. The horse dies. In this case, the contract becomes void because of destruction of subject matter of contract. So it is not possible for A to give that horse to B. Now whatever A has received, A has to return that, repay that 2000 rupees to B because the contract has become void. So this is restitution. So whenever any person has received something in a contract and that contract becomes void contract, that party who has received, he has to return it to the person from whom he has received it.